Head tracking for sim racing is a subject we've covered many times on the channel before, testing out different methods and discussing the results. And recently a subscriber mentioned Beam Eye Tracker in a comment. I've never heard of this software before then, but I figured it was worth investigating further as it is unique. It claims to offer AI-powered head and eye tracking, needing nothing more than your webcam and no other specialist hardware. And of course, I am running Beam Eye Tracker right now. The circle darting around the screen is tracking my eye movement. It's a feature that's built into the software. It's an overlay that you can hide from view, but for the purpose of this review, it makes sense to display this for the demonstration. The preview at the top of the screen is the webcam view the software is using for its tracking. Also note, Beam Eye Tracker makes use of OpenTrack, so you do need to install and run the free OpenTrack software at the same time. If you're not familiar with OpenTrack, it is the widely used track IR emulation software that's compatible with all games that support head tracking. So that does mean Beam Eye Tracker works with all games that feature head tracking since it piggybacks off OpenTrack. And finally, it's worth knowing that the developer offers a 2-hour demo. That's on Steam, so you can try before you buy. So next up, I'm going to run you through a quick setup guide. Nothing too deep, but enough to get you up and running quickly and some basic tips along the way. For everything else, you're free to explore the software in your own time. So the first thing to do is install Beam Eye Tracker from Steam and OpenTrack from the OpenTrack website. I'll drop links below the video. Once you've done that, launch Beam Eye Tracker. It will appear as a tray icon on your desktop. Now make sure Game Extensions is turned on. That's required for OpenTrack to register the output from Beam Eye Tracker. The eye tracking overlay is optional, but useful for monitoring the accuracy of the tracking, as you saw just moments ago. Next, click on the cog icon to open the main window. There's lots of sliders here for tuning, but to begin with, you can ignore making any changes. You may find the default settings good enough, like I did. Take note, there are two tracking options, head or head and gaze. Head just tracks head movements. Head and gaze combines head and eye tracking. Now we're going to use the quick setup option to configure the software. First, select your webcam from the device drop-down list. Then next, for the best results, it's important to set the fastest frame rate at the highest resolution the webcam supports. After that, just follow the simple on-screen instructions. I'm performing this final part from my seated sim rig position to ensure it's configured properly. I'm not wearing my glasses for this stage as they do interfere with the eye tracking. I'll cover this later in the video. What we're doing is peering at those points on screen to calibrate the tracking. With the eye tracking overlay active, you can see the tracking fully calibrated and working. Next up, we're going to head over to OpenTrack, so launch that application right now. Let's power through this so we can get on the track. Select Eyewear Beam as the input and hit start to check it's working. The octopus should mirror your movement, and that means it's up and running. If it's not, just check that Gaming Extensions is turned on, as that will be the problem. If it's greyed out, it's off, so just click it to turn it back on. Now you could just jump into a game and the head tracking will function, however the game will look something like this. And it is almost undrivable as the default settings in OpenTrack need some tuning, but at least we can see it is working, so we are going in the right direction. Since I've already adjusted my OpenTrack settings, I'm going to share my configuration file with you. There's a link in the description. All you need to do is drop the file into the folder and you're good to go. And then select the profile. You also need to bind a button or key to center the view. Every time you start a game, you'll discover that the view in front of you won't be straight on. It might be at a sort of strange angle, and the center function is used to correct this. All you need to do is look straight ahead and tap center. Using my OpenTrack config file, the head tracking will look something like this. Now you can go ahead and adjust things further in both OpenTrack and Beam Eye Tracker, but this video isn't a tutorial, it's a review. However, I did want to show you how to get up and running quickly at least, so hopefully that's been useful. Okay, so let's move on and talk about the performance. It's called Beam Eye Tracker, and that gives the impression that it's just tracking eye movements, but in actual fact, the software tracks both head and eye motions. So consider them as two separate physical elements, as this is exactly how the software handles them. It's more easily explained through this demonstration. With my head locked looking straight ahead, and my eyes darting around, you can see the on-screen marker tracking the movement. Also note the cockpit view angle motion is slight, though you can tune this in the software to alter this measure. And this is the head tracking, giving me a full 6 degrees of freedom of movement in my space. I'm running over the top settings here to exaggerate the on-screen motion so you can clearly see the effect working. For Simracing, you'll tone things down to something closer to this, whereby the head movements are realistically matching the on-screen viewpoint. I found the accuracy of the eye tracking is generally within a 10% margin of error. When I pinpoint a location on my screen, if it's not dead on, then it's about 2 or 3 centimeters out. If you turn off the circle overlay, you won't be aware that it's not 100% all of the time, because it is close enough to do the job. The eye tracking is smooth and low latency. There is a micro delay, though quick enough whereby to notice it, you really need to focus your attention and study the overlay circle as it updates the position. Considering it manages to perform this feat as well as it does from a 2D camera feed is mightily impressive. When I draw my eyes to the four corners of my monitor and the left and right edges, that's where the eye tracking accuracy can struggle. The tracking still manages to key into the general area where my gaze is focused, so it's around about correct, but I do notice there is a sweet spot where the eye tracking is most effective. While I'm racing here, I'm not looking at the edges of the screen, so it's not a limitation that has any real negative effect. I would also suggest that the eye tracking accuracy will be affected by the size of the monitor, as your head and eye movements are greater if you have a large monitor in front of you and that static webcam is trying to lock on to your face and eyes. For reference, my monitor is 38 inches. Since the tracking is of two halves, head tracking is its own component, and the head tracking is excellent. It's stable, accurate, and consistent. I really can't find any faults with it. It just works and keeps up and seems to track my movements without any obvious latency. So although the eye tracking is mostly getting the job done, it's not 100% perfect by itself. But as it runs alongside the head tracking, which is working really well for me, and it's the combination of both working together that balances it all out, giving out a very good end result. A question that some of you will want answering is how does it handle glasses? Well, it is hit and miss, as the frame of my glasses is getting in the way of the webcam view of my eyes, so it's partially working, but not good enough to rely on. It jumps around too much to be useful. However, don't forget, we also have head tracking, and in the settings, you can turn off eye tracking and just use the head tracking. And the good news is, head tracking is unaffected by glasses. It works perfectly. And I can't deny, head tracking alone is more than sufficient for racing games. I can't comment on other uses, including flight and space sims, but I would say the active eye tracking feature isn't necessarily essential for racing games. So if you do wear glasses, Beam Eye Tracker will still do a fine job, just leaning on the head tracking function, and you won't be missing out even if you're not using the full feature set of the software. Overall, a very capable application, is quick and accurate, making it very well suited for racing games. Bear in mind, your webcam will determine the tracking quality, including the capture frame rate, of the camera. Also make sure you have decent lighting, as that will help too. And you're free to find out for yourself using the demo, so you can ensure that your setup is suitable before committing to buying the full version. So give it a go and drop a comment and let me know how you get on. And finally, thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next one. And until next time, happy simming and bye bye.